Hi, Steve Hughes of Hands On Physics Education. I'm down at Dohles Rocks that you can see behind me, one of my favourite video haunts. And today I want to talk about twilight, that gap between night and day. And the interesting question is, why is it still light? Why is the sky still light when the sun has gone below the horizon? And it's because light is scattered in the atmosphere. And so the atmosphere acts like a channel, channeling the light over the horizon so that it's still bright. Now, if we were on an airless body like the moon, it would go immediately dark as soon as the sun went below the horizon. Now, the twilight is actually divided up into three divisions. We've got civil, nautical, and astronomical. Now, the definition is that during civil twilight, you can do the everyday civilian things of life, like mowing the lawn, for example. Then in nautical twilight, you can see the brightest stars and the horizon at the same time. And that's important for navigation, where you need to measure the height of a star above the horizon in order to be able to work out where you are on the Earth. Then that's followed by astronomical twilight, and that's the time it takes for the sky to become fully dark. You can see some of the stars at the end of astronomical twilight. You can see all of the stars and the full glory of the heavens is revealed. Now, a more technical definition is that, this is my model sun, it's when the center of the sun, when it's on the horizon, that's the beginning of civil twilight. And then when it's 6 degrees below, that's the end of civil twilight and it's the beginning of nautical twilight, another 6 degrees, and then that's the period of nautical twilight, and then the final 6 degrees from 12 to 18, that's the period of astronomical twilight. So let's imagine that we're standing on the equator at either the spring or autumn equinox, so equal day and night, 12 hours of day, 12 hours of night. So at 6 in the morning, that's sunrise. The sun comes up 15 degrees, that's 7 o'clock. Then another 15 degrees, that's 8 o'clock in the morning. And then at midday, the sun is vertical. It's 90 degrees up from the horizon. It comes down. So at 45 degrees, that's 3 o'clock in the afternoon. And then the sun is back on the horizon at 6 o'clock at night. So it goes down 6 degrees over 24 minutes on the equator down there. So that's civil twilight, another 6 degrees nautical twilight, and the final 6 degrees, that's astronomical twilight. Now, the length of twilight, that's going to vary depending on where you are on the Earth. So the maximum is 24 minutes for each of the sections on the equator, making a total of 72. In Brisbane, it's a bit longer, about sort of roughly 27 minutes for each of the twilights. And as we go either down towards Antarctica, the Antarctic Circle, or up to the Arctic Circle, so twilight becomes longer and longer. So I'm down at Dohles Rocks on the 2nd of October 2023, and today civil twilight is from sunset, 6:48 to 6:11. It's about 6 o'clock at the moment. And then nautical twilight, that's from 6:11 to 6:39. And then astronomical twilight is from 6:39 to 7:06. So periodically, I'm going to describe what I can see in the sky, which is likely to be a bit different from what can be seen in the camera, the video cameras, iPhone 12, that's actually brightening the scene. I can obviously see the screen and I can see the scene at the same time and it's a bit brighter. The car's got their headlights on, as you can see, and also the lights on in the house opposite. It's now 6:11, right on the boundary between civil and nautical twilight. The horizon can be clearly seen with the naked eye, and I can see at the moment just one star in the sky. I'm not sure if it's going to come out on the video. I'm pointing the camera straight at it. I'm not quite sure what it is. I think it could be Alpha Centauri, one of the pointer stars to the Southern Cross. I think that will become apparent as twilight proceeds. So I'll go pointing south and out towards the east there. Full moon was a few days ago, so the moon is still below the horizon. It's now 6:25, halfway through nautical twilight, and the horizon can be clearly seen. It's very clear on the video, but I can see it with the naked eye. And the star, which I thought was Alpha Centauri, is Alpha Centauri. It's one of the two pointer stars. I think you might just be able to see them in the video in the center of the field of view, and I can make out the three brightest stars of the Southern Cross. I'm not sure if they're going to come out on the video. And then of course there's a lot of activity over by the airport, and then pointing east and up there in the center of the field of view is Saturn. Until it's Saturn, it's not twinkling. And also I had a look on Stellarium on my phone, and to the right of it is a star, Fomalhaut height. I may not have pronounced that correctly. And I can see several other stars in the sky if I point my camera up there. In a northerly direction, you can see some stars. So quite a few stars which can be seen all around in nautical twilight. In the middle of nautical twilight, some people just arrived back at the jetty on their boat with their navigation lights on, the red and the green. It's now at the very end of nautical twilight and the beginning of astronomical twilight. To see the boats being taken out of the water and they're driving off with it. The camera's pointing towards the west and we can just see the remnants of sunset on the camera, but I can just about make out the horizon there. Those red lights are the Bald Hills AM radio transmitting tower, and the bright lights on the horizon there, that's Brisbane. I can't see them very well with the naked eye, but they come out on the video. Then that other glow is the port of Brisbane and the airport, and then the Horney Brook Bridge, which is to the east. Then I can't see the horizon, and the camera can't either. So that's the end of nautical twilight and the beginning of astronomical, and there's a lot of stars up in the sky. The pointer stars to Southern Cross and the Southern Cross below, but I still can't make out the fourth star. I did just then, so I just see the fourth star of the Southern Cross. See the three brightest, and then just see the fourth one. Now 6:52, which is the middle of astronomical twilight, I can now clearly make out the fourth brightest star of the Southern Cross. The horizon below is fairly bright. That's deceptive. These are artificial horizons. That's, I think, probably towards the Brindale industrial estate before. I think it might have been the remnants of the sunset. West is directly over there, can't see anything, maybe a little bit. And then we've got the lights of Brisbane over there and the port of Brisbane and the airport over there. Then out across the Horny Brook Bridge, and far in the distance will be Moreton Island, which we can never see from here. So middle of astronomical twilight. 7:06, we're now at the official end of astronomical twilight and the beginning of night. But not quite the same as it would be in the outback. In the outback, there would be no artificial lights and it would be really dark, and the full glory of the heavens would be revealed. So this is as dark as it's going to get, but quite a few stars up in the sky. Might not come out too well on the video, and someone, as you saw earlier, setting in for fishing during the night. So that's the story of twilight.